Meanwhile, President Trump has still refused to concede the election more than a week, as we said, after the Associated Press called the vote for President-elect Joe Biden. Michelle Sinder has that report.
Who knows which administration it will be? I guess time will tell.
Defiant and divorced from reality, President Trump spent the weekend on the golf course and on Twitter. He repeated familiar, unsubstantiated claims of fraud, and he continued to refuse to admit defeat, instead spreading disinformation. I concede nothing, he wrote Sunday, dashing hopes that he was slowly realizing he'd lost. Earlier, he wrote of President-elect Joe Biden saying, quote, he won because the election was rigged. That seemed to at least acknowledge the result of the election. Meanwhile, GOP leaders, including House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, are still supporting the president's refusal to concede.
Regardless of how this outcome is, you want to be able to trust the election. If there was something that was wrong in this election, we do not want to repeat it for the future either.
Former President Barack Obama hit back on Republicans on CBS News Sunday in his first remarks since November 3rd.
The president doesn't like to lose and never admits loss. I'm more troubled by the fact that other Republican officials who clearly know better are going along with this, are humoring him in this fashion. It is one more step in delegitimizing not just the incoming Biden administration, but democracy generally. And that's a dangerous path.
With the country divided on trusting the election results, thousands of supporters of President Trump took to the streets of Washington, D.C. There they enjoyed a visit from the president, who waved from inside his motorcade. The event drew thousands of people, but did not live up to its name, the Million MAGA March. It also did not live up to the Trump campaign's estimates, including White House Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany's false claim that the crowd tallied more than 1 million. By day's end, the initially peaceful gathering turned violent in some cases. Clashes between pro-Trump and anti-Trump protesters resulted in 21 arrests. 4 police officers were also injured, and 1 person was stabbed. Earlier today in a press conference, the district's police chief, Peter Newsom, praised his officers' handling of the event, but decried the circumstances.
To see our country having those types of physical disputes over an election, that's something we attribute to other countries across the world, but we don't see that here in the United States, so that's the worst of it for me.
Though a peaceful transition of power remains in question, President-elect Biden expressed confidence that his team would be prepared come January.
I am hopeful that the president will be mildly more enlightened before we get to January 20th. I find this more embarrassing for the country than debilitating for my ability to get started.
And outside the Capitol, the work to put on the inauguration 2 months from now continues as workers construct the stage where the winner will take his oath.
This evening, President Trump is continuing to double down on his false assertion that he is the rightful winner of the 2020 election, refusing to acknowledge that Joe Biden is, in fact, the president-elect. Now, critics say his behavior and his rhetoric is dangerous and could imperil American democracy. But President-elect Joe Biden says he's moving at full speed with his transition, even though he doesn't have all of the resources needed and even though that transition has not started officially. Now, the Biden campaign is hiring, and they're expected to announce senior staff positions as early as tomorrow, sources tell me. And while the Biden campaign is hiring, the Trump campaign is letting people go. On Sunday, a majority of the Trump campaign staff ended their employment. So while the president is continuing his legal battles, he's doing it with a much smaller staff. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Yamiche Alcindor at the White House.